Tootley sewage treatment plant. And we're just about to do some pulls. Got a coffee. Donut. The bottom of donut. Alright, so just so that you're aware, boost gauge. On the console here, I'm sure if you can see. Taco. Speedo. Sports sharp mode. So we change the sports sharp. Throw the diff to the back. So we're auto rear bias. That puts less pressure on our transfer case. Traction control off, completely off. We hold that down for 3 seconds. Reverse. Take the truck up. Turn around. Now I'll leave the interior lights on for the time being. And I will wind the windows down just a smidgen, enough to allow there to be minimal road noise. Alright, and let's give it a pull out of here. Main road. Let's go. Jimberry clutch is known for being an excellent quality race clutch. It is a single plate, but it will hold up to 400 kilowatts. So Jimberry makes all the race clutch for the cars that participate in the events such as Targa Tasmania and Phillip Island, a lot of those races, especially the classic car races. The Jimberry clutches are an amazing clutch. They feel soft underfoot. They are much better road feel than the stock clutch even. Very, very soft, very light, very forgiving. It's got a smooth but consistent linear grab point. And they're strong as buggery. The nice thing is that when you go with the Jimberry, you can have the benefits of a single plate, which means it's more street friendly, with the added benefit of it being extraordinarily strong and holding up to 400 kilowatts. Now this car makes about 350, maybe 350, maybe plus a little bit, give or take, depending on the tune and the weather. So when I'm talking 50 kilowatts buffer between the safety capacity of the clutch and the car, you know, you've got plenty of room to move. The clutch will not blow. So I can rely on using that clutch when I need to, especially on a pull. The other thing is the Jimberry clutch, because it's a single plate, means it is that it has got a linear grab and a fairly decent grab distance. And it's not like a dual plate, which is kind of like a switch button. You know, the problem with a dual plate is it really just grabs suddenly. It doesn't have a linear grab point. So once the first plate in the clutch grabs, and the second plate will then suddenly grab after it, the car's either engaged or it's not, which means you're generally revving the tits out of the engine just to pull away from a red light, and you've got to catch the revs on the way down. With the Jimberry, I can treat it like a normal street car, and as you can see, it drives just like a normal street car with the normal clutch under normal driving circumstances, but I can give it a flogging under race circumstances if I need to. Anyway, that brings us to the house, and that'll wind the video up for today. I will fill you in on the timings, which you should have already seen by now. I'll post them up in the video below the runs, based on the speed in the camera. Pulling into my car spot now. It is early in the morning, so I'm about to wake the neighbours again. So I live next to a concrete buffer, which with my car makes everything a lot louder than it needs to be. Anyway, that's it though. So thanks for